tension will be a dangerous kamma, so I should not do it. So with understanding, with reflection, we can slowly make our actions much more wholesome, much more, so the akushala element can drop off and kushala element can increase. So that's the kind of practice which we have to do. Okay. So all these things which I, about 7 minutes, what I wanted to tell, all these elements are therefore elements of practice. Dana has to be not only given, done, it has to be reflected upon, reviewed upon and seen whether I have done it with the right motivation. Following of Shila, am I doing it out of fear of the government or am I doing it out of understanding of the law of karma? Am I doing it so that I reduce my craving and aversion? Because Shila is also to, when you say will not speak, tell a lie, will not indulge in ill will not indulge in backbiting, will not indulge in slander. So we are actually improving the quality of our mind. So once we see that our whole objective is to move in the direction of purity of mind, because that is what will lead to the following Dhamma in accordance with the teachings of the Buddha, then everything will fall in place. So then, having done this background, this was the background of, then we come to the main teaching of the Buddha, practice of the Four Noble Truths. I think we've discussed it so much that now you should tell me. So we'll take one by one. So this is the, I've just taken that jo maine wo dikhai thi na aapko matrix, uska ek ek element maine isme dal diya. So aap bataiye, somebody has to explain again. What is the practice? In fact, it is written, actually I should not have written it. It is written on the top. Pariyatti is the first column, Patipatti is the second column, Pativedan is the third column, penetration is the third column. So now you please explain, we have discussed it so much, somebody should explain. Yeah, please.
Understanding of insight, knowledge of truth, basically pariyati of suffering. What is to be done? So what is suffering?
It is written here. I don't have to tell you. It is written. Patipatti is to be understood. Now, how does one understand suffering? Yeah, batao.
So then we jump the truth of dukkha. So truth of.
Yeah. What does it do?
Okay. So truth of dukkha is that basically
somebody has just abused me very badly and I am feeling very bad. Now what do I do? How do I understand it?
So first thing I have to understand is that a person is abused and I am definitely feeling bad, but my feeling bad or the suffering, the main cause is not the person, but my perception of what the person spoke, how I took that thing personally. So
you're jumping to the next. You're jumping to the second.
Okay.
First also is important.
Okay. Yeah.
Of course, this example was trivial, so maybe you could easily jump.
Right. So if the person abuses me, I'll definitely get angry and I'll feel bad. There will be two things. One is sorrow. One will be anger. So both the things are suffering. They will be not physical suffering. They will be the mental suffering. And whatever the person says, when I add my own perception to those words, how I have taken those words, like the suffering will be increased and it will continue. Like it is like two arrows example that you gave.
What do I understand? Understand kya karu main? Yeah, you say there will be suffering, will be mental phenomena, it will have its effect on the body also.
So that it
then
is
what do I understand?
Okay.
It
so what I understand that this is suffering. What I hear, when I hear something which I don't want to hear, it is suffering. When I don't hear what I want to hear, it is suffering.
I had sent a note in which three examples.
Okay, sir. Khandas.
No, you can do it at the level of the first.
Khandas.
Or you can do it at a more gross level.
Okay.
So, The Buddha defines suffering in so many ways, isn't it?
Yes, from birth to aging, disease, death, to be with the loved ones, to be separated from the loved ones, and to be with the those people we don't like. So this can be one of those cases that apriya ke sang, apriya ka
association
sang.
With unpleasant.
So aversion is definitely, so this is I think one of the major causes.
Okay. And if you have to take it to khanda level, what do you do?
Then sir, it will be sound, yeah, definitely sound. Sound may which khanda, sanya, vinyan.
I am identifying with something, na?
Yes.
Because the result of which the words are causing suffering.
Yeah.
What I am identifying with?
So, इसमें कुछ थोड़ा बहुत विज्ञान भी है क्योंकि harsh words आ रहे हैं और percept थोड़ा बहुत संन्या भी है because I don't expect a person to say that or suddenly the person speaks such a thing which I don't want to hear and definitely थोड़ा बहुत इसमें संकार भी है because aversion create हो रहा है and if I am not mindful that aversion से मुझे further to an extent mainly sanya.
Anybody else would like to add? How do we understand it really in such a depth that it leads to other things following immediately?
It leads to
second, third, fourth. Okay. Because basic idea वही है ना. प्रथम आर्य सत्य की समझ इतनी हो, it should be so understood that the cause is revealed, isn't it? So then, once the cause is relieved and let go, cessation is experienced, isn't it? That should be the outcome of the understanding. That's the way these Thai Ajans teach us, isn't it? Ajans में तो यही कहते रहते हैं सिर्फ और तो कुछ कहते ही नहीं हो. You want to say? Yeah, Shankar ji wants to say, yes. हाँ जी कहिए.
Shall I speak about to be understood?
हाँ हाँ बताइए ना.
तो जो उसमें दुख के बारे में है, यम पि क्षम न लभती तम पि दुखं. हम तो कभी भी गाली पसंद नहीं करते किसी से भी, गाली चाहे कोई अपना हो सगा हो, हमें whoever is either relatives own son or own daughter or wife or otherwise other persons, we do not desire to have abuses. Even we desire to have
that part has been sorted out, no? Okay. She said it belongs to the category of appriya. Let me complete. It belongs to the category of appriya hi sampayog dukho. Apriya cheez se sampayog hua, association hua, aur dukh ho gaya. Wo to utna to ho gaya. Ab hum keh rahe the कि अगर हम इसको संकेत इन पंच उपादान खंदा दुखा, कैन वी सी इट, आर वी एबल टू सी दैट? इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी टू सी इट, आई एम जस्ट
बिकॉज़
सेइंग दैट
बिकॉज़ देयर इज अ सेंस ऑफ अत्ता.
नो, सो व्हिच खंदा आर यू ट्राइंग टू से व्हेन यू से संकेत इन पंच उपादान खंदा दुखा? सो फाइव खंदास, दीज आर दीज अटैच्ड, द क्लिंगिंग टू देम इज द कॉज ऑफ सफरिंग. सो व्हेन
कॉन्शियस
समबडी इज, किसी ने मुझे कहा तुम तो बिल्कुल मूर्ख हो, तो मुझे क्यों बुरा लगा, तो उसमें किस किस खंड के प्रति अटैचमेंट हुई? ये लुक अननेसेसरी बट इट हैज अ वेरी डीप मीनिंग बिकॉज़ इट विल ब्रेक अप ऑन द सेंस ऑफ सेल्फ ऑटोमेटिकली.
इट वुड बी कॉन्शियसनेस, विज्ञान.
और बोलिए, इज दैट सो?
According to me, sanya, perception of myself is being challenged.
Yes. Therefore, I do not like it.
Yeah. I have a perception of myself as a very intelligent person and somebody tells me you are a fool. So, it is a conflict. So, there is one with that, isn't it? Then, there will be other, this is the prominent one, but of course, there will be other things also. When somebody says something, then I have unpleasant feelings. And those unpleasant feelings also I take, oh, मुझे अप्रिय लग रहा है, so I get the, I kind of grasp those unpleasant feelings also. So these are the two prominent things which are getting. So I'm identifying with perception, I'm identifying with feelings. In this particular case, the most dominant is likely to be the perception, isn't it? Now, what does it, how does it help? How does this understanding help? Can you visualize it?
Then the perception needs to be understood more. Firstly, into that, into dukkha, anatta and anicca, if you could take it forward into those realms. The first is, it is my clinging to my perception about myself, which is giving me dukkha. And then, obviously, it is temporary because it is the cause of conditioning. The conditions outside are deciding what my perception is. Tomorrow the condition changes, the perception will also change. So it is impermanent. And third one, anatta, I don't know.
On conditions.
Even I'm trying to figure that out. So.
हाँ करके देखिए भाई, आई एम सेइंग सो इट मे साउंड टू यू कि क्यों कर रहे हैं फालतू की बातें, करने की जरूरत क्या है, बट अगर आप इसको ठीक से करेंगे ना तो होल थिंग विल कोलैप्स, जस्ट कोलैप्स लाइक दिस.
नहीं,
आप इसको जैसे आपने मान लीजिए आइडेंटिफाई कर लिया कि परसेप्शन इज द मेन प्रॉब्लम, अब उसको कॉम्प्रिहेंसिवली देखिए ना. How would you see it? See it comprehensively, no? So just reflect. Assume, let's just sit quietly and assume, you can just do a thought experiment, ki kisi ne aapko gali de di, kuch keh diya. And then see how what effect it is producing and how you are really trying to interpret it. Because understanding means how we are interpreting it. And if you understand that, then everything else falls flat, because it just, you've just broken it apart into parts and there's no essence in it.
मैं थोड़ा सा attempt करना चाहूँगी.
Please try.
मेरे को किसी ने बुरा बोला और मैंने feel किया. जब मैंने feel किया तो फिर मुझे संवेदना हुई जो कि बहुत जलन या कुछ ऐसा हुआ जो कि आई वॉज नॉट कम्फर्टेबल विद. एंड देन आई सी इट एंड उस वक्त देख करके मुझे जो महसूस हुआ उसको ये तो नहीं बोलूँगी कि बहुत ऐसा देख पा रही हूँ कि बहुत ज़ोर से कि और परसेप्शन जो वाली बात है वो दैट कम्स विद मी लेटर ऑन when I think about it actually, matlab it's not a simultaneously I'm thinking, but that perception, I will understand that there is a perception of my like there is a, I have perceived certain things, that's why I wanted to do or wanted him to act in certain fashion. And jab wo mere usme nahi aata to then I feel very bilkul bekar. और फिर उसके बाद में देन आई सी कि दूसरे वाले का भी कुछ परसेप्शन होगा जिसमें शायद वो कुछ सोच रहा होगा. वैसे वो उतना सोच नहीं पाती हूँ लेकिन फिर भी कोशिश करती हूँ कि पॉसिबल है क्या. लेकिन दैट कि मैं बोलूँ दुख के ऊपर, आई विल सिट ऑन इट एंड वॉच, दैट्स I am not able to do it, but this I could make out ki there is a strong, you know, there is a perception which is holding me aur bahut zor se kya kehna chahiye, main ka bhav to mujhe phir bhi bahut dil late se samajh aata. Then again it's an intellectual process which I maybe ponder on it and then think ki ye this is a possibility, but at that moment I just feel very uncomfortable and I try and see myself at that moment. That's the only thing I can do.
What right do you mean by seeing yourself?
Seeing in the sense ki एक तो मैं संवेदना के तरफ से भी देख सकती हूँ, मतलब वो
दैट इज आदत पड़ी
अभी आदत, हाँ वो ही है,
सो दोस्त छोड़ना,
हाँ लेकिन एक मेंटल भी नजर आता है अब कि एक छोटा सा कुछ, हाँ कुछ है जो कि देयर इज समथिंग मतलब एडिशनल टू दैट, बट स्टिल आई एम नॉट एबल टू रिकॉग्नाइज व्हाट इज इट, बट हाँ देयर इज सम चेंज कि मैं संवेदना के साथ साथ देयर इज समथिंग आई कैन ऐड आल्सो, मतलब आई कैन सी समथिंग कि ये चीज़ थोड़ा डिस्टेंट होकर के भी देख पा रही हूँ, लेकिन बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं.
ओके, हाँ जी बोलिए.
व्हेन देयर इज ग्रास्पिंग ऑफ,
प्लीज डोंट से इट थ्योरी, पुट इट इन प्रैक्टिस. आप ये अज्यूम कर लीजिए कि आपको मैंने कह दिया कि आप मूर्ख हैं, अब आप बताइए कैसे उसको हैंडल करेंगे.
मैंने अब उस फीलिंग को पकड़ लिया.
हाँ नहीं, अब आप उससे मुक्ति कैसे पाएंगे ये बताइए. उस जो आपको उससे दुख हुआ मेरी बात सुन के, आप उसको ये चार आर्य सत्यों को समझने से कैसे मुक्ति मिलेगी. दैट इज़ द की थिंग ना, बाकी सब तो थ्योरी बात है कि हमको ऐसा करना चाहिए, वो नहीं, हम क्या करें उसको उस सेंस में देखिए ना, तो फिर बड़े दैट विल बी वेरी हेल्पफुल, है ना, दैट विल बी हेल्पफुल.
तनाव ना जगाएं उसको जो है हम ग्रास्प ना करें.
नहीं, हमने तो कर लिया, दुखी हो रहे हैं, अब क्या करें. आपने, चलिए आपने मुझे कहा तुम महामूर्ख हो, ठीक है, और मुझे तो दुख हो गया. अब एक तो ये तरीका है कि मैं देखूँ परेशान हो रहा हूँ, ये ऐसे ही हैं वैसे ही हैं, ये तो बिल्कुल कुछ नहीं है, पता नहीं क्यों नाराज़ है मुझसे, ऐसा कह रहे हैं, ये कह रहे हैं. और या दूसरा है, यार बहुत बेचैनी हो रही है, चलो शरीर में कुछ गड़बड़ हो रही है, चलो उसी को देख लो यार, छोड़ो इनकी बातों को, छोड़ो शरीर को देख लो, कुछ संवेदना भरी अनप्लेजेंट हो रही है, मन में बहुत बेचैनी हो रही है, थोड़ी देर शांत बैठ के देख लो, देख लो, देखते 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 धीरे 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 मन शांत हो जाएगा, कुछ देर में शांत हो जाएगा. देखते ये हुआ, फिर ये सब पचड़ा क्यों कर रहे हैं हम. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट आई एम ट्राइंग टू पॉइंट आउट, आई होप यू, आई विल बी एबल टू कन्वे इट. मुझे मालूम नहीं, वाई एम आई सेइंग टू यू, देखो अंडरस्टैंड करो ये सब करो क्यों.
सर
हाँ जी, हाँ जी
सर, क्या जिस समय ये सब कुछ हो रहा होता है और हम समझ जाते हैं, डेट इज टू बी अंडरस्टूड, जब हम समझ गए तो उस सिचुएशन से हम उसको बेटरमेंट की तरफ ले जाए सिचुएशन को. सपोज़ किसी ने मेरे को बुरा कहा, अगर मेरे को पता लग गया कि उसकी परसेप्शन है कि मैं बुरा हूँ, तो शायद मैं सॉरी कह के उसका मन भी हल्का करूँ और अपने आप को भी अच्छे तरफ ले जाऊँ, खुशी की तरफ, आनंद की तरफ, कि वो भी सिचुएशन को काम डाउन करके सब कुछ अच्छा करने की कोशिश करें. मेरे हिसाब से ये मैं समझता हूँ. अगर उस वक्त हमें समझ में आ गया है कि ये मेरा मैं का भाव नहीं है, ये वो सोच रहे हैं, तो लेट कि हम उसको सॉरी कह के फील अच्छा कर दे, फील गुड.
गुड, वेरी गुड, बेटर.
क्षमा करके, फॉरगिव करके उसको.
हाँ वो तो आप, दो आर स्ट्रेटजीज ना,
किसी ने
स्ट्रेटजीज हुई ना. मैं पूछ रहा हूँ, अंडरस्टैंडिंग की बात कर रहा हूँ मैं, अंडरस्टैंडिंग से कैसे मदद मिलेगी वो समझने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, है ना. अंडरस्टैंडिंग से कैसे मदद मिलेगी, एक एक करके ना.
वन साल सी वट एवर इज़ हैपनिंग विद इन मी. जैसे सपोज मैंने ड्राइव कर रही हूँ और मैंने शायद ओवरटेक कर लिया और दूसरे वाले ने मुझे जाकर के थोड़ा सा और कट किया और मैंने उसको आई जस्ट गिवन हिम बैक कि तुम कैसे आगे बढ़ो. देन आई रियलाइज ओके दिस इज़ समथिंग विच इज़ यू नो माई ईगो विच इज़ कमिंग इन एंड आई एम हार्ड यू नो. एक तो आई एम वॉलेटिंग द ट्रैफिक रूल्स एंड देन आई एम ऑल्सो नॉट ड्राइविंग इन अ you know civilized manner. So then I will correct my action after you know understanding that, so that will be immediate, I think. So that's that's
okay, but we still are not got into that key.
Sir,
element which I am trying
to
point
out.
So we
put it like the four noble truths. Now we know one thing, that there is suffering. And we also have come to the fact that there is a cause of suffering, which in this
right.
case
I'm
a perception.
I am asking you just this much. How will my understanding suffering, what does it mean? So example, if you understand that suffering is due to perception. How will it help me? Kya fayda hua isse? आपने कुछ बताया उन्होंने महाराज जी ने बट ट्राई टू वर्क ऑन इट फर्दर
सो वन पाथ विल लीड टू इग्नोरेंस द अदर पाथ विल लीड टू निब्बान सो वी कुड स्टे इन दैट साइकिल वेयर वी स्टे विद द सफरिंग एंड बट वंस वी हैव अंडरस्टूड दैट दिस इज हैपनिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द कंडीशंस because of my karma I can steer towards another route sir
yeah that is a method of how to overcome suffering you know isn't it that's a strategy that's one a very wholesome strategy I'm not saying it's wrong there's nothing wrong in these thing answers I'm not saying that I'm trying to point out to you something as to the importance of to be understood
sir it's ignorance for sure But when the incident is happening, it's happening so fast that a person cannot really analyze it.
Yeah, that's true.
So then you go back to reflection, as you said. And when you're on the reflection mode, and then you kind of recap that whole incident, and that's when you realize that the suffering was ignorance because of the perception that I have created of myself. You understand it at times you don't understand it. But I think that reflection mode, when you are reflecting on that incident again and again, you take it on like a screen, like a video. I mean, like a movie. And for me, I think that's where. You can kind of, I mean, sometimes it's very easy to say that you can be aware of it by your respiration or your sensations, but when the moment it's arising, it's, I cannot do it. I mean, many people could do it, but I'm at least, and then you realize on the reflection mode that there is ignorance over there to a certain extent, and is the consciousness of the ear with the salayatan the ear consciousness heard something and then the sankhara hand something is the process but we can reflect it only when you are sitting and reflecting in a calm
mind. that's true it may not be easy to do it at that moment but let me tell you how I understand it You want to say something?
Your question was that what is the importance of understanding suffering? So, in my opinion, it's the only once you understand it, it will lead you out of suffering. Yeah. So, I think that's
what exactly. That's why we took some element, na? Jee example liya. Uska ek element tha ki. This is appiyahi sampayoga dukho. That was one element which we understood is fine. That's true. Then I said, you can take it to a second level of understanding. Which khanda is really prominent, which I am holding on to, which is causing suffering. You know, sankhittena panchupadana khanda dukha. So, jaise humne discuss kiya, usse clear hua ki kai ghadmat to hote hi hai na, sare khanda ikatthe ud jate hain. But prominently perception ki issue hai. कि भाई परसेप्शन मेरा अपने बारे में कुछ है उसका कुछ और है और इस कारण से क्लैश हो गया और परेशानी हो गई तो हम ये जानना चाहते हैं कि उस अंडरस्टैंडिंग से दुख मुक्ति में और आगे क्या होगा उसका सो लेट मी जस्ट बिल्ड ऑन फर्दर आई थिंक महाराज जी हैड सेड इट ऑलमोस्ट यू सी इन द पास्ट लेट मी जस्ट शेयर विद यू इन द पास्ट वट आई यूज टू डू से यू गेट अपसेट And you see, there is causing unpleasant feelings in the body, unpleasant feelings in the mind. Just sit with it for some time, observe the body, observe the sensations, and it gradually quietens down, and you are free from suffering in some time. Now, what happens? What I do? We had an occasion recently, something of that kind. So I just saw. There's a clash of perception between my perception on certain issue and perception of somebody else on certain issue. I said, okay, it's hurtful. Okay, we'll reflect on it. It was not possible to do it at that very time, as he said. Situation was extremely dynamic. So I said, okay, let me keep quiet, let me have the sense restraint not to react. I'll reflect on it deeply and then find out what exactly is going on. And then after the event, when I reflected, I could see it was just a difference of perception, so we can then see it out, and the matter ended immediately. And as a result, what happens? You see that your tendency to assess, my tendency to assess myself based on certain perception, somebody else's tendency to assess me on the based on his perception. And they are all impermanent, they are all changing, they are all conditioned, and naturally, depending on the conditioning, there will be differences. So the whole process of suffering arising because of perception is attenuated. So next time if somebody calls me that, the chances are the suffering will be much lesser. So I don't have to even understand it because it won't be there. In due course, the change of perception will not cause any suffering. That is his perception, that is my perception, we'll see about it. There won't be, in this particular case, there was some element of suffering, you know, some undiscomfort was there. But as you see through it thoroughly, you actually get out of suffering. The perceptional differences will no longer cause you suffering because you have seen it again, you have seen it happen 10 times. Yeah, your perception ke karan hota, to hell with it. Dekh lenge baad mein, abhi kya, kis baat ko kya mahatv dena hai. To uska kuch hai, mera kuch hai, kisi aur ka kuch hai, kya karunga, kahan tak main isko sambhalta rahunga. Why do I think my perception is right for lighting, isn't it? So then, it has two benefits. First, it's not that suffering arises and then you seize it, suffering does not arise. That is what is meant actually by Nirodha. And he says, Dukkha Nirodha, it means it does not arise. It doesn't mean that it arises and then you do something and it ends. It means it just doesn't arise. And secondly, it creates disenchantment with the perception. Dukhi kar rakha is perception is badi hell. Kabhi kuch. So you move in the direction of disenchantment. It's done with it. Bahut ho gaya. And so you are moving and then practicing according to the teachings of the Buddha, because he says, whatever you do, if it leads to disenchantment with the khandhas, you are doing right thing. That is the asset test. If it leads to disenchantment, if it leads to understanding that they are impermanent, that they are not yourselves, that they are cause of dukkha, all that is clearly understood in this process when you break it apart. So when you break it apart and do that, then you have got panya, you are developing panya. When you just observe sensation and pull it, then it's a good strategy, it will reduce suffering. But you have not developed panya in the process. At best you have to know it's impermanent. You have not been able to see, break it to the level of seeing it, and they are not me, not mine. And these khandas inherently are cause of suffering. You know, kuch nahi kar sakte bhai. Ye dukh denge hi. So you really become more and more clear, and then that general kind of sense of disenchantment, and that's the key for moving towards the noble path, that you then, it gives you a push that you should walk in that direction, not in this direction. In this direction I have walked enough, now I should walk in that direction, which will pull me into the direction of the stream of liberation, not in this, because in this I have tried enough and seen, building up high perception of myself, keeping the body strong, being strong from feeling for perception, having a very strong ability to analyze, having very good habit patterns. You know, sankharas are good, very good kamma, good habit patterns. Still, you are still caught in the same domain. You are caught in the domain of khandas. You just can't get out of it. This is the domain of the mara. You can't get out of it, whatever you may do. So you develop that inspiration or urge or samvega to move in that path. Ye samanyata strategy laga ke suffering se to dur ho jayega, lekin mujhe chutkara nahi milega. I'll remain tied up in this very domain. So that's the beauty of understanding. You know, you understand it at the khanda level, then you see all these characteristics of khanda, impermanent, unsatisfactory, not mine, and they lead to disenchantment. So all the conditions are fulfilled. And once you do that, everything else follows through. You know, then origin of dukkha is known. You know the origin of dukkha. You just see it and put it aside, and you experience the cessation of suffering. So they just follow straight. You understand it through, and you go to 1, 2, 3, just follow immediately, if you understand it at that depth.
So, when you said, when you're reflecting and you have a chattering mind, it's, the chattering mind is either of the future or the past, is chattering with some thoughts or the other, is chattering. And you mentioned that, please leave me alone. I mean, it's a perception. Is your perception of those thoughts that are coming in is either past or future or something? And you say, shut up, you know, you because is that the right? You are penetrating that moment, or what would you call that?
I was trying to explain this, you know. If the mind is too much chattering, you can't do that. What I meant was that you just get fed up with the tendency of the mind to stick to perception, for example, in this particular case. Similarly, fed up with the tendency of the mind to stick to feelings, stick to the habit patterns, stick to the sankharas. So you get really, many times I actually, when a thought comes, I say, shut up, and it just finishes. Because there's practice, there's a back of practice, you know. There's this practice of samadhi to such an extent that if I say, just shut up, no more thought of this kind, it will just stop. Now, that's a question of practice. I won't say it will happen with everybody, I don't know, really. But when the practice is good, and you realize that I don't want to get into this thought process, the thought process will stop.
Okay, so the thought process will stop, I mean, that suffering will also stop, I mean that...
No, I'm so talking of the, we are basically talking of the understanding of suffering, you know.
Right.
When we understand suffering at the level of khandhas, and you are able to see the impermanence, the insubstantiality, you don't take it, you don't say my perception is right and his perception is wrong.
True.
Once you have seen through, the suffering will just fall.
Right.
Because you have seen the unreliability of the thing on which was causing suffering. So once you have seen the unreliability of perception, suffering will just collapse.
Right, so like the,
it will not carry forward.
So suppose there are 2 persons, me and 1 person. We are continuously creating conflict on same point again every day. I start looking at the way you have explained. Fine, it's my perception, it's her perception. And I could see impermanence, I could understand khanda perception, even the unsatisfactoriness. But anatta wala thing jo hai, ke totally impersonal wali cheez, wo I am not able to.
No, it's not that you will get a vision of anatta.
Okay.
It is an understanding that how did my perception form based on certain conditions.
Right.
Isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
And so, if the conditions change, the perception will change.
But even
so, once I understand that, it's a question of understanding. Na? So once you understand that something is formed because of certain conditions, then I can't say it mine and my belonging to me.
Totally.
It's just formed by conditions.
As such, condition change for a day, perception also changes.
Perceptions keep on changing, Perceptions about things, about people, about situations, about weather, about food, it keeps on changing.
And so sometimes this thing happens that a person says something like, after you continuously reflect, a person says something, it doesn't affect you, it doesn't, matlab thoda sa, I mean, and you don't even know ki ye kaise hua, usme aapne perception ya reflect bhi nahi kara hai, but it stops.
Yeah, that you have to investigate and find out. That's the key beauty of it, you know, when you develop that habit of investigation, then it becomes a joy to be able to investigate and find out, why did I suffer yesterday? Because then you get confidence, you know, you have the joy that I can investigate. And investigation is Dhamma Vichaya. Dhamma Vichaya is Panya. That's how Panya develops. So the joy of being able to investigate one's own suffering and get out of it is very, it's a really wholesome joy. After that, if you sit and meditate, you'll be absolutely, mind will not go here, there, anywhere. Direct concentration will be enormous, because you've got a basic factor there. So the point of all this discussion was that if we understand dukkha in the true sense, you can understand it in the sense of first four elements of that, jati bhi dukkha, jara bhi dukkha, marana bhi dukkham, appiyehi sampiyogo dukkho, appiyehi vipiyogo dukkho, sankit, and then yamapi icham nalabate samapi dukkha. Many times this understanding will also lead us to an understanding of the cause and then putting it aside. But if you break it up to khandas, then you are really following the teaching of the Buddha to the hilt. No? As I showed in the first slide, for each khanda you should do, find out, it should lead to the, whatever practice leads to understanding the impermanence, the unsubstantiality and the basic in unsatisfactory nature of the khanda and leads to disenchantment. That is the practice according to the Dhamma. So that's what I am trying to point out. If you do it like that, then everything falls flat, you know, it just from first to second to third is immediate. It just happens immediately. And then you have insight, oh, this is what is happening. This is what is happening. This is what Buddha means by Sankittena Panchupadana Khanda Dukkha. This is how we can identify. Of course we know this, it's not just one khanda which is going to operate, but that is a prominent one. Usually one of them is prominent in one particular situation, and then you can see that and let go of it. And then as we go do it again and again and again, then our attachment to khandas, our confidence in them, our ability to hold on to them and trying to take them personally, that slowly is kind of rubbed off. And as it is rubbed off more and more, then it's not that then we have to really work for removal of suffering, because suffering will not arise. That is the beauty of it. You don't need then strategies to come out of suffering, because it won't arise. You have seen through it. You have seen through the cause in the root cause, if I may use that word. So once you have seen through the root cause, then it doesn't matter. Then you have other reflections which help us. Once you put them all together, they help us in building upon this way of understanding.
Sir, if I reflect on the scene of suffering, replay the scene again and again with the understanding of impermanence of nature of suffering and anatta, understanding of anatta, the suffering should reduce.
If the understanding is proper, it should definitely. It
if
should
I replay again and again,
it should not arise.
I will replay.
It should not arise. Kindly see the difference in the words. I'm not saying suffering should not reduce. I'm saying it should not arise. The more we develop this understanding of five khandas, the less will be the arising. That's what is meant by nirodha, dukkha nirodha. Dukkha nirodha is not that suffering arises and then it will go. It means it will not arise.
Sir, it will be applicable for sukh wala. Like this is all when you are getting some situation where you are not finding it good. When you are happy.
Yeah.
You will do the same thing.
Yeah. You're just, if the happiness is moving in unwholesome direction, you know, the state of happiness is going towards excitement, taking it personally, towards pride, towards arrogance, then obviously it gives you suffering. Happiness by itself is not our objective.
Of course. Yes.
The search for happiness is actually the cause of suffering, isn't it? So you have to understand that. Mm-hmm. Happiness in the worldly phenomena, isn't it? The objective of the sadhana, as I mentioned in the beginning, was that with respect to the five khandas, we should see their impersonality, their unsatisfactory nature, their impermanence, so that the whole sense of self which we build upon is demolished, is kind of seen as a ghost, something which does not exist and we have created it. So that's the teaching of the Buddha, that Dhammana Dhamma Patipandaya. This is how a person follows Dhamma according to Dhamma. That's what we are discussing. We are not discussing strategies for getting out of suffering. That we have already studied, you know, discussed in the earlier classes, that you can do this, you can do that. There are so many things which we can do, and there are very healthy things to do. There's nothing wrong in it. We are just trying to go a bit deeper than that. Trying to see how the understanding of the teaching, Panchupadana Khanda Dukkha, how that understanding can lead to elimination of suffering and reduction in our identification with the khandas. And the less we are identified with khandas, less will be the arising of suffering. That's it. If we retain identification with khandas and we work only on strategies, suffering will keep on arising.
I'm not on that. I'm just saying the same rule, like we will segregate each, like when we are happy.
Why should we do analysis of when we are happy, really happy?
That's what I'm asking you, ki whether we'll do the same thing, we'll see Sangya, will we do that thing also? I mean,
if I am peaceful and happy, there's no reason for me to do any investigation.
So only that
I can only reflect. I can reflect if I am, since I am still following the path and not really always happy and not always in a state of peace, I'll then reflect, oh, what are the elements which gave rise to happiness? Okay? And then see, it will always be, I did not create craving, I did not create aversion, I did not create delusion, and that's why I am happy. So I develop my understanding of path still. So I use the happiness experience also to develop an understanding of path. That's what probably you are asking. Yes?
So I want to ask you one question, and I'll put it up with a small example, which is quite a stupid example. In a Goenkaji retreat, there was a student and the teacher called him for checking. And he says, do you get sensations? So he says, yes, I get sensations. So he says, how do you meditate? So he says, you know, I make a image of mine in front of me, and then I look for sensations on my shoulder, I look for... So this whole process, what you are explaining is fantastic, is making a lot of difference. But I am stupidly making an image and trying to find, hey, where is the cessation of dukkha and the patipati and the pativeda? And I'm looking for it when I'm reflecting what you're saying.
It is here.
I know. But the stupid mind is creating an image and it says, hey, where is the third noble truth and where is the first noble truth and the three parts of it? And I'm trying, because the khandas are moving so fast. I mean, if you understand, you know, and I'm symbolizing myself with that man who was creating that image to find the sensations.
It's a matter of changing the habit.
Yes, sir. The other point is, I don't find it. Hmm. Then I say that I'm not practicing right, because I couldn't find those the noble truths and the three parts of each noble truth. So they should be 4 × 3, 12 parts. But sir told me this cessation of dukkha to be realized. Where do I look for to realize it? You know, I mean,
it's not that complicated. Let me explain it again. It's not. Of course, the investigation into khandas needs a bit more practice. But if we remember the basic teachings, we can easily see that suffering could be due to old age, death, illness, which are physical counterparts of unpleasantness. It could be due to the mental aspects of it, you know, association with unpleasant people, words, situations, and then separation from pleasant people, situations, then wanting something and that not getting fulfilled. These days, young boys are getting admissions in colleges, they want here, they don't get it, they get somewhere else, and suffering. So that this is the basic paradigm which Buddha says. But and then, since we are all very senior meditators, meditating for a very long time, I am therefore inviting that let us move next dimension also. Of course, if you are confined to this also, then you can identify, okay, this is association with unpleasant is causing suffering. So, and we understand, therefore, that's the craving which is arising. There's the craving of the, or the aversion, you know, the tanha is of the kind of aversion. So it is aversion which is arising toward these words. And then I try to practice that, I should see that perfectly. So that will be practice at one level of aversion, you know? Practice at the level of trying to see the arising of aversion, and then identifying aversion as the cause of suffering, and then letting go of that aversion and feeling the freedom from suffering. So that is the one which we can do at one level of operations, quite simple. What I am trying to put it is that if you walk at the level of khandas, you then are able to kind of break apart the delusion of I, the sense of I. And once you walk at that level, then the if you develop that habit of seeing these khandas operating again and creating suffering for us, then that habit slowly gives rise to our ability to kind of see these khandas separately and not me and not mine increases. And then the tendency of the external impingements of the world to cause suffering will come down, because we have reduced down the sense of I, and we have reduced our attachment to the khandas themselves. So the tanha which arises based on vedana, and that has its root at association with the body, association with the feelings, association with the perception. So we are taking it to that depth level. So if we find it difficult to do the investigation into khandas, we can do in that level of aversion, and that also. So we identify, for example, in this example, identified, oh, these words caused aversion in me. So tanha is the aversion, and I know I should not do aversion. I just put it aside. I put the aside aversion, and then of course I can keep continuously mindful of the body, because being mindful of the body is very important in an investigation. And I'm mindful of the body, what is happening, and I'm also aware of the tanha. I've done that much of investigation, and so tanha should be let go of. So I leave it, and then suffering will cease. So by practicing in this manner, we are also developing our path. We are developing the path at a level of seeing the arising of tanha and putting out the aversion less. So that also is perfectly fine. But if you want to develop deeper, then the tendency of I somehow remains. No? I am putting it down, I am doing this, I am doing that. That in a very subtle way that remains. So to be able to get through that, it seems to me that if we can identify the khanda and then see that this khanda, in sometimes it will be perception khanda, sometimes it will be body khanda, sometimes it will be feeling, sometimes it will be habit pattern which I grasp, and see these khandas are really cause of suffering, and then develop that disenchantment with them, you develop that sense of non-identification with that, and that's really the way which when we will be able to do practice in accordance with Dhamma, as was mentioned in the first slide, you know, that you develop disenchantment, develop anicca, anicca jasanya, anatta sanya, dukkha sanya with respect to the khandas, so that you can put them aside, you can then no longer be troubled by them. So that is the, that's why I mentioned that. Yeah, to be able to, if you have to practice, is a more deep level. But if you can, if you practice at the other level, that also is good enough. It's not anything which is not wholesome or healthy or not advised, certainly.
So in a nutshell, it means that I have to have a very highest form of awareness.
Yeah, mindfulness has to be there.
That is the basic need.
Yeah.
To do anything of this sort.
Yeah. Mindfulness is the key thing.
Is the key thing.
Understanding and mindfulness. Two things are very clear. Yeah? Achha, bolo, sorry. Because of sunlight, I am not able to see.
रिसेंटली एक इंसिडेंस हुआ, ऐसे वॉक कर रहे थे और एक टक्कर लग गई. एंड आपने हैबिट पैटर्न की अभी बात करी, तो विदाउट थिंकिंग, विदाउट एनीथिंग, इम्पल्सिवली डैम इट डोर, धड़ाक डोर, डोर को बैंग करा. अब वो संखार तो हो गया. अब सर उसमें फिर मैंने सोचा ये कौन सी, इसमें संज्ञा तो है नहीं, ना ही इसमें थोड़ा सा विज्ञान है कि पेन हुआ टच, बट इज दैट सम ओल्ड हैबिट पैटर्न, या इस चीज़ को हम कैसे, ऐसे ऐसे इम्पल्सिव रिएक्शंस को हम कैसे इन्वेस्टिगेट करें?
आपने उसको बाद में घर आके इन्वेस्टिगेट करने की कोशिश की थी?
हाँ जी सर, मैंने सोचा ये संज्ञा तो है नहीं इसमें, बिकॉज इट वॉज सो फास्ट, मुझे एकदम गुस्सा है और मैंने एकदम डोर बैंग करा जस्ट, और कोई लिविंग बींग जस्ट डोर एंड मी, तो
आपको
कोई एकदम धक्का लगे, आप बिना सोचे उसको धक्का भी.
सो दैट इज द रिफ्लेक्ट मैनी, आई मीन टू द एक्सटेंट आई कैन सी, बट ऑब्वियसली यू कैन सी इट बेटर देन आई, सो यू हैव टू सिट एंड figure it out with yourself. You sit quietly again and figure it out, you'll find out. Definitely find out.
Sir, I have a question about these steps that we follow, that incident happens and then we follow step by step, what, which khand, and then supposing directly we go that something, there is a verbal dude or something follows, and then I understand that it is perception and this is my self-belief that is not agreeable between the two. Or something.
This analysis is needed when things are muddled up, you know. When things are so obvious, then it's pretty straightforward. You can just put it aside. You can just leave it aside. Once we can see clearly that it is just our perceptual issues, and then you can put it aside and then don't make a big issue out of it and try to create conflict. Then the suffering will not arise. The key factor is that if I am able to see where exactly the shoe is pinching, suffering will not arise. The moment I see, for example, that you are telling me something and I see, it's called perception, mere se alag hai, mera alag hai, that's all right. You know, it happens, you know, when, if, for example, you can see it in the past elections, kitna hungama hua hai. Do dost hain, ek ka perception hai, ye party achi hai, dusre ka perception hi achi hai, and they fight about each other, unnecessarily. If you realize that your perceptions are different, you don't discuss it. Yaar, kya karna discuss karke? Humko malum hai, bhai, tumhara perception ye hai, mera ye hai, khatam hui baat. Ab na wo theek hai, na main theek hoon, usme kya karna? Why to fight and create a big issue out of it? So the suffering is not going to arise if both are intelligent, isn't it?
Sir, arise to hoti hai, jab tak tumhe samajh mein nahi aata ki perception, wahan tak to hoti hai.
So it takes time for us to understand it and to see our perception also with pinch of salt, if I put that. If we see our perception also with a pinch of salt, then there is a possibility. If I say, mera to theek hai, uska hi galat hai, phir to gadbad ho jayegi. Then there is very difficult. Hai na? Agar mujhe ye kahun, jo ajancha ki baat hoti hai na, not sure. That's very, very great mantra for us. Lagta to hai ki main hi theek hoon, but I'm not sure really. You never know. It especially happens with such important issues of things of where they're not directly involved with us, but and then they can cause fights and I mean it can reach to violence. Good. So
sir, एक और आपने कहा था because the perception is not ours, it is the condition, belongs to condition.
All lifelong conditioning we have gone through.
हाँ, it is the condition which shapes it. उसमें एक humility आती है, नहीं आ रही. So I don't know. I mean, is that supposed to be the next progressive step or what? But yeah, I'm not experiencing any.
So you sit. Humility. I would suggest you sit with it and first understand what does humility mean. What does it mean? What do I? You're feeling that humility is a good quality which you don't have. So this is a good reflection what will it call? It will be called as Sammavayama, isn't it? Sammavayama says that wholesome qualities which I don't have, then I try to bring them in, okay? Then I sit, okay, let me try to bring it in. Why is it not coming? And then just sit with it, don't think, just sit with it. Calm down the mind, and then as the mind becomes pure, you'll know. You'll know yourself. Once you understand what humility is, you'll know what is the cause, where exactly is the sense of pride emerging, sense of achievement emerging, sense of attainment emerging, which is not allowing me to be humble, isn't it? So you'll know that. The power of reflective investigation is very profound. Only thing we require is the mind should be calmed down. So that is very crucial. So whenever we do reflection, we should first practice something, anapana or whatever method of meditation we adopt, to calm down our mind. And then put that question. Okay, why am I not humble? Just leave it at that. And then keep on your practice, whatever you want to do to quieten, keep the mind quiet, and it will emerge. The question will come. The question will kind of germinate within you and sprout. And when it sprouts, it will tell you, oh, this is it. Now that's a question that may be look like a faith at the moment, isn't it? But it does work like that. I can say it. It does work like that. My experience says that it does work in that manner. We have had very interesting experiences in the past, and I could see that, how suffering arises and how justice is put off. And just because of my mental projection, suffering became so much, and all kinds of, the whole world is about to collapse, and then it just collapsed. Once I saw it, just collapsed. I was prepared for the world to collapse also. It's not that the world didn't collapse, or even before it, whatever happened, I was prepared. Okay, the world collapses, that's fine. So then the suffering will not happen, isn't it? So, and that happened, it took me 2 days, not one sitting. So, but that's why I'm confidently saying it works.
Ajahn Amaro said that he had this anxiety issue and he pursued it for 2 years. How exactly do you pursue it? As in, you do reflection once, then you get an answer?
You sit firstly, calm down the mind, and then remember this event causes anxiety. And you just, so you have an event which must have happened in day-to-day life, you just remember it, and then see what is happening. Where exactly is the root of that anxiety? Yeah, it will be in some khanda somewhere, or multiple khandas somewhere. And then you say, oh, this is the what I am grasping, let me put it aside. And you do it again and again, because it is so easy to grasp it and put it. It's not easy to put down your sankharas, for example, habit patterns. So difficult to put them down. But you do it again, again and again and again. That's why it takes time. Stronger the habit pattern, large time it will take. But that's how you really get free from there. No, it's not a question of handling the habit pattern. It's a question of getting free from that. That's the difference. Okay? Fine. So then we are nearing the end. I think we have just 10 minutes. I'll just expose this part and see. You know the Eightfold Path? This is the Fourth Noble Truth. What are the eightfold? Naam mein nada chala. Somebody should do it. Then? Okay, then?
Wise livelihood, wise speech, wise.
Okay.
Samadhi, concentration, Shila.
Shila is done. No? Yeah, in concentration there are how many factors? 3 more factors, no? Sammasati. Sammasati. Sammavayama first. Sammavayamo, Sammasati, Sammasamadhi. Okay? So these are the 8 factors. So when we say We have already seen first three noble truths. Pehle teen noble truths ki practice to ho gayi, isn't it? Now this is the fourth noble truth. Uski practice humko karni hai. To uski practice mein karna kya hai? Humne kuch to kuch kafi kuch to hum kar hi chuke hain abhi tak. Kya kuch kar chuke hain? Ye daan shil restraint humne experience kar liya. Iski practice karenge. To isse kya hoga? What are the things which will take care? Dana takes care of part of wise resolve. Shila takes care of all these three things: wise speech, wise action, wise livelihood. Sense restraint takes care of wise resolve, because you have, you know, avyapada sampakko, ahimsa sankappo, and it also takes care of wise striving. You don't allow unwholesome thoughts to come in, take out the unwholesome thoughts. So part of these are done. So in a way, the preparation जो हमने भगवान ने कही करने को, उसमें पांच एलिमेंट तो हो गए, पांच डायमेंशंस जो थी पाथ की वो तो हो गई इस प्रिपरेटरी प्रोसेस में. थोड़े थोड़े पार्ट एलिमेंट रह गए, वो सब आपस में मिलकर हो जाएंगे. सो दैट इज द, यू नो, इन अ सटल वे, इन अ वेरी सटल वे विच इज इजीली अंडरस्टैंडेबल बाय हाउस होल्डर्स, ही हैज टॉट अस द एट फोल्ड पाथ and told us already about the five elements of the noble path. So for us who understand this in totality, now all that remains to discuss in case of the fourth noble truth is just these three things, isn't it? Ye teen cheezein reh gayi, ab inko kaise develop karein? This is the what we should develop, and we'll discuss it in the next class. Aap bhi sochiyega inke bare mein. Some questions I'll just leave it with you. Is there any relationship between them? Just think about that. In teenon mein aapas mein kuch relationship hai kya?
So without wise mindfulness, we won't get a wise view. What's the cause? What's the
effect? So you think about it. I'll give you a hint also. See how we do anapanasati. And then see what is the relationship between them. And also remember, what are the conditions for jhana? What are the conditions for satipatthana? You remember? In satipatthana, jo hamara shuru mein padhte hai na, jahan char satipatthan ki baat aati hai, to har jagah wo baar baar kehte hain, vinay loke abhijja do manasam, vinay loke abhijja. Sun sun ke kaan pak jate hain. Kitni baar kahenge bhai, ek baar sun liya hai. Har 2 minute mein vinay loke abhijja do manasam. They are prerequisites. उसी तरह ध्यान के बारे में क्या कहा जाता, विविच्य कम कामे ही विविच्य अकुशले ही धम्मे ही, कामनाओं को त्याग करके और अकुशल धम्मों को त्याग करके. तो आपको ध्यान करने हैं, सब ट्रैंक्विलिटी मेडिटेशन करनी है, चाहे सतीपट्ठान करना है, इंसाइट करनी है, ये प्रीरिक्विजिट्स हैं, ये हमको भूलना नहीं चाहिए. तो ये सब जो हमने किया, शील और उसके दान और सेंस रेस्ट्रेंट, दे आर ऑल प्रीरिक्विजिट, तो कुछ तभी सतीपट्ठान का काम हो पाएगा. अगर मन सतीपट्ठान, अगर मन में दो किसी के प्रति एक्विजिटिवनेस का भाव है, लोभ का भाव है, संग्रह करने का भाव है, या किसी दुर्मन दौर्मनस्य का भाव है, किसी के प्रति द्वेष का भाव है, तो ना सतीपट्ठान हो सकता है, ना ही ध्यान हो सकते हैं, ना ही समाधि का अभ्यास हो सकता है. सो ये जो पांचों चीज़ें थी, वो सब उसकी प्रिपरेशन थी ताकि हम इस डायरेक्शन में काम कर सकें. ठीक है, सो आई थिंक वी शुड स्टॉप नाउ. इट्स ओके, विल सी इट. अभी तो देर हो गया, बिकॉज 6 o'clock पीपल हैव टू मेडिटेट ना, देयर इज अ टाइम फॉर मेडिटेशन, सो वी शुड स्टॉप. So in fact, do some metta chant and they pay respects to the triple gems.
Bhavatu sabba mangalam, rakkhantu sabba devata.
sambuddhanubhavena sada sutti bhavantu me bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkantu sabba devata sabba dhammanubhavena sada sutti bhavantu me bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkantu sabba devata sabba sanghanubhavena sada sutti bhavantu te arhan samma sambuddho bhagava buddhang bhagavantang abhivademi sakkhato bhagavata dhammo dhammang namassami supatipanno bhagavato savak sangho sanghang namami.
Thank you.